My name is Pavel Vychik, and today I'm going to talk about application of semi-automated inference of bacterial transcription factors binding sites to regulatory network analysis and producer strain construction. Genomic data continue accumulating nowadays. Here on the picture provided by Sigmoid Genomic Browser, you can observe a fragment of genomic annotation, which represents a typical annotation available in GenBank. In most cases, only open reading frames and corresponding protein products are annotated with lack of information about regulatory sequences such as promoters, transcription factor binding sites, and terminators. The core of Sigmoid application is the de novo operator motifs inference pipeline implemented in user-friendly graphical interface. Currently, it covers motifs discovery for 24 major bacterial transcription factor families. Sources and executables of the application are available via the link on slide. Every transcription factor contains DNA binding domain, which is responsible for nucleic basis recognition. Visualized crystallographic data presented on slide demonstrates that only few amino acid residues in exact positions are involved in specific interaction with DNA sequence and formation of the stable transcription factor DNA complex. Amino acid residues in these positions are called critical residues, and one could assume that these positions are conserved within each DNA binding domain type. Amino acid residues in critical positions constitute a CR tag that indicates the ability of individual transcription factor to recognize specific operator sequences. So the sequence of critical residues can be used as a unique identifier of transcription factor operator motifs pair. A typical picture of transcriptional regulator targets is exemplified by NTRC genomic locus. This transcription factor autoregulates its own gene and one gene GLNA located nearby. Looking for conserved patterns within the corresponding regulatory regions gives mostly operator and promoter motifs, which could be further discriminated by operator width. This approach gives improvement over phylogenetic footprinting because we look for operators only in genomes that encode transcription factors with the same CR tag. Based on above mentioned assumptions, the NOVA operator inference algorithm collects regulatory regions for transcription factors with the same CR tags, which is further used for inference of conservative patterns using MIM or ChIP-MAP. The result of the pipeline work is a set of putative operator motifs compared with the library of characterized motifs. This scheme demonstrates the pipeline workflow. More details about the pipeline are available in Beata 2020 talk by Evgeny Nikolaichuk. We have improved the pipeline by adding more transcription factor family models, implemented motif inference for transcription factors with two DNA binding domains, adjusted CR coordinates for several existing transcription factor families according to the new structural information. All these improvements allow Sigmoid to infer motifs for over 80% of transcription factors in most bacteria. There are two major questions that one could be interested to answer with help of the operator analysis. First, what are the regulon members for a given transcription factor? And the second, which transcription factor controls the gene or operon of interest? Finding the answer to the second question is far more time consuming because it requires analysis of operators for all transcription factors encoded in genome. A typical MIM output for our data is redundant because the collection of regulatory regions contains binding sites for various transcription factors, which are discovered by pattern search algorithm as operator motifs with different statistical significance. Instead, a user could annotate all operators with de novo motifs inference pipeline results and proceed manual with operator analysis in the genomic region of interest. This scheme represents implementation of the genome-wide operator annotation in Sigmoid. First, the user provides the folder with the de novo pipeline search results for transcription factors families of interest. Second, operator motifs marked as statistically insignificant by MIM are dropped from usage in further workflow. On third stage, motif significance threshold for further scan using nHammer is calculated based on the model information content. Then manually created motifs are added for annotation on later stage. If there is a CR-tag match with transcription factors present in the genome. I should mention that Sigmoid library of manually curated motifs currently contains around 3,000 calibrated motif profiles. Acquired sets of motif models are used by nHammer to infer putative operators with regard to the model significance threshold. All found operator sites are checked for duplications annotated in genome file, which is visualized in Sigmoid genomic browser. This picture demonstrates the results of Pictobacterium versatile genome annotation with operators of 24 transcription factor families. Total 1,694 motifs models were annotated. Most of the in silico predictions made with Sigmoid were experimentally verified in plant pathogen bacteria, Pictobacterium versatile. Its genome contains over 250 transcription factors. 50% of them belong to 12 major transcription factor families. Its top three by transcription factors count, LISAR, RSC, GNTR families. We have interest in the transcriptional regulation of Pictobacterium versatile virulence factors. So the presented approach was used to infer putative operators in the regulatory regions of corresponding virulence genes. Here we have experimentally confirmed FOP transcription factor sites in PIL-I, PIH-A divergent control. The qPCR measurement of PIL-I and PIH-A genes demonstrates the difference in wild strain and FOP mutant. Also, our RNA-seq data confirms this observation. Operator analysis suggested DCUR transcription factor involvement in DCTP-QM operon control. This suggestion was confirmed with DCTP-XLE reporter gene expression measurements in a culture medium with malate, which is a known DCUR inducer. One more demonstration comes with FOP involvement in XPI expression. Inferred putative FOP sites in XPI region are confirmed with qPCR data and the difference of acylhomocysteine lactone production in the wild type and FOP mutant strains. Of course, our approach has some pitfalls. Here on slide, we can see some of them. First, transcription factor binding sites inference pipeline finds correct motifs in around 70% cases, but correctness criteria for unstudied species are vague. Second, motive significance threshold determination remains tough. Both false positive and false negative operator annotations are possible. Third, calibrated motifs library vastly improves operator inference, but size of this library remains limited. A short resume, genome-wide operators analysis simplifies experimental planning and gives valuable clues for interpretation of experimental results. Presented in silico, operator inference approach could be applied for generation of testable hypotheses about implicit transcriptional regulation in bacteria. Strict application of genome-wide operator inference could be the basis for search and analysis of regulatory chains and networks. Thank you for your attention.